Good afternoon, everyone. This is Marie Sullivan, and prior to or before I call this meeting to order, I want to hope that all of you are staying dry and unscathed due to the monsoons that we're experiencing. Also want to re-welcome all of us to another academic year, and I know it's going to be a great one. Also hoping that all of you enjoyed a healthy and fruitful summer. It's been a long time since we've been together, and I know you're just all very, very excited that here we are once again. So again, what I'd like to announce is that we are live captioning our meetings. And if you wish to engage, please look in the chat window of our Webex meeting where you will find a link. Please click on that link to open a web page with the live captioning and you're good to go. So with that, at this time, I call to order the agenda review meeting of the Maricopa County Community College District Governing Board of August 17, 2021. Today, we're going to review the agenda for the August 24, 2021 board meeting. And for the record, I'm going to call a roll for the board members. And I'd like to both welcome Mr. Quentin Evans, our student trustee, and ask if you're present.
I am present, President Sullivan.
Thank you. Ms. Bittersmith.
Here.
Thank you. Mrs. McGrath.
Present.
Great. Mr. Dr. Narini.
I'm here.
Good. Ms. Smith.
Present.
Great. Dr. Thor.
Present.
Thank you. Ms. Nguyen.
Present.
Thank you. With my presence, we have a full quorum of the board, with including our student trustee, 7-0. So we have a short agenda review. And as we scroll through what's on our screen here, for the next meeting, you will see that there's the general activities under the board meeting, beginning with the call to order and moving in all the way through to our chancellor's report. There being, I assume, no comments on any of that. There will certainly be a citizen's interim on our meeting. So far, we've not heard that anyone would want to present. We're open to that possibility. And then the next item on our agenda for next week would move to consideration of the consent agenda. So with that, I'm going to say that item 2 through 5 reflect approval of faculty emeritus distinctions for Mr. Bass, Mr. Clare, Ms. Lynch, and Mr. Zager. Are there any comments? Being none, the next item on the consent agenda, approval of the appointment of James Washington as the Healthcare United Gateway Clinic Administrator. Any comments or questions? Being none, the next item is item 7, approval of the Healthcare United Way Gateway HUG biannual report for spring 2021. Maricopa County Community College District on behalf of Gateway Community College. Are there any comments or questions? Being none, item 8, approval of the U.S. Department of Education award for the TRIO Upward Bound program at Gateway Community College. Any comments or questions? Item 9, approval of new grant award. U.S. Department of Education Higher Education Emergency Relief Fund, Fund 3 formula grants, minority serving institution allocations. Any comments or questions? Item 10, approval of acceptance for new grant award from U.S. Department of Education to Estrella Mountain Community College for student acceleration, growth, and engagement, SAGE project. Any comments or questions? Moving on to item 11, approval of acceptance of continuing grant from U.S. Department of Education to South Mountain Community College for 5th year of TRIO Upward Bound Award. Any comments or questions? Item 12, approval of final guaranteed maximum price contract amendment number 2 for the life science and physical science remodel and expansion project at South Mountain Community College to McCarthy Building Companies. Is there any comment or questions? Item 13, approval to increase the 3-quote procurement threshold for construction, remodeling, and maintenance projects from the current 100,000 on our form, I have an extra 0, to 500,000. Any comments or questions?
This is Sullivan.
Yes.
This is Ms. Swin. I have a question.
Yes, please go ahead.
Is this an forever increase, or is this a one-time increase to handle certain projects? So are we permanently increasing this, or are we just doing it for the 3?
Dr. Gonzalez?
Yes, excuse me, President Sullivan, Mrs. Swin, let me call in Gary Aquinto, who may be able to help us with that question.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Gonzalez. President Sullivan, members of the board, everyone, I'm Gary Aquinto, Chief Financial Officer for the district. The answer to the question, as I understand it, is it permanent or temporary? This would be a permanent change in our protocol.
Mrs. Wynn, do you have any follow-up comment?
Well, it's a 5 times increase, so I know the cost of construction has gone up. Is that what predicated the need? Is it the age of our buildings? There, obviously, this is a substantial increase. So is there any justification? I just kind of want to know the thinking if we're raising this level at this time.
President Sullivan, Ms. Wynn, it is a permanent change, and the additional increase in construction costs is part of it, but it goes well beyond that. And perhaps a little bit of background would be helpful in this case, starting with the fact that every purchase order that is over $250,000 goes to the board for approval now. And every purchase order above $100,000 goes to the Capital Development Advisory Committee. Both of these thresholds will remain in place. What we're seeking with this item is to allow purchase orders up to $500,000 to be based on obtaining 3 competitive quotes. Currently,
excuse me, just a moment.
Yes, sure.
Mr. Aquinto, we're getting some incredible feedback.
And I hear the gurgling sounds as well. I'm not sure where it's coming from. Sounds like they stopped.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Thank you. We missed a little bit of what you were saying. I apologize.
Yeah, and I apologize as well. Basically, what we're saying is that all of the current thresholds for bringing purchase orders forward to the board are going to remain. And really what we're seeking to do with this item is to allow purchase orders up to 500,000 to be based on obtaining 3 competitive quotes. Currently, for what we call single trade work purchase orders, those that require only a single trade or a limited additional work, right now, we only have 3 options for bringing those purchase orders forward. We could either use a cooperative agreement, which is to piggyback onto another jurisdiction's contract with a vendor. We could do job order contracts, and you've seen several of those from us. You'll see one on this agenda as well, but those come with a markup involved. Or the third option is we can issue an RFP for that work, which is a long process. And usually we don't like to do those for projects that are not complex or complicated. So by changing the 3 competitive quotes up to 500,000, it would allow us to add a 4th option for these kinds of contracts, not requiring a substantial design phase, And by seeking the three competitive bid option, we add another tool to our toolbox that we think will result in cost savings by enabling greater price competition. And our facilities planning and development folks, based on the amount of work we do in the range between $100,000 and $500,000, estimates that we could save anywhere from 10 to 30% by putting this additional tool in operation. So it increases competition. Yes, prices have gone up, but it's the competition aspect that is really driving the reason to bring this forward.
And once again, to reiterate your comment, this doesn't impact any, has no effect on the board's current approval process or our thresholds. So I appreciate you reminding us and reiterating that as it's stated in the agenda material that we received. But with that, Mrs. Nguyen, another question or comment?
Oh, no, I was just going to say thank you for the comprehensive response. And
you're welcome.
And I like the idea of the three quote procurement threshold. So I think that that's a great thing. And I do appreciate being reminded that we still have an opportunity to look at everything over 250,000. So thank you, Mr. Yukinto.
Thank you. And with that, we'll move then to item 14, approval of job order contracting purchase order in the amount of $566,328 to Cayente Construction Inc. to replace the hot water line at the physical sciences building at Glendale Community College. Are there any comments or questions on that? Okay, being none, we'll move to item 15 on the consent agenda as presented, approval of intergovernmental agreement between Maricopa County Human Services Department and the Maricopa County Community College District on behalf of Rio Salado College for a contract with Maricopa County Head Start 0-5 program. Any comments or questions on item 15? Hearing none, the next item 16, approval of intergovernmental. Yes, someone speak? Hello? Okay, moving to item 16, approval of intergovernment agreement between Maricopa County Community College District for Arizona Small Business Development Center and the City of Peoria to provide one-on-one counseling and training services for City of Peoria businesses. Any comments or questions? Being none, item 17, approval of collaboration agreement between Guild Education Inc. and Maricopa Community College District on behalf of Rio Salado College. Any comments or questions? Okay, so what I'm hearing as of now, there is no further comments or questions on any item on the consent agenda as it will be presented at our board meeting. Okay, so with that, then we would move beyond into the agenda for our first reading information on employment and separations from May 15, 2021 through July 23, 2021. Any comments or questions on that at this time? Being then from there, we'll go to the monitoring reports. For the items noted, budget analysis report fund 1, general unrestricted fund for the 12 months ending 6/30/2021, and budget analysis report fund 1, general unrestricted fund for the 1 month ending 7/31/2021. Are there any comments or questions on that? Okay, well, that presents most of what we know as of today to be on the agenda. I believe this will stand as is. If there's anything pressing or anything changes within the next day or so, please inform Dr. Gonzalez's office and we'll move forward to add that. From this portion of the meeting, we will then move to the community linkage reports with the governing board members reporting in. I know, so are there any comments or questions on today's agenda before I move to the next piece? Boy, you guys, you must have had a really good summer and just, you know, all of us are trying to get back into it, right? With that, then, I know that we're scheduled for our board meeting next Tuesday at 6:30, but I do want to make an announcement on that meeting. So as you know, on August 12th, 2021, our interim Chancellor Gonzalez announced a requirement that all individuals, including community members and district visitors, would wear facial coverings while indoors at any of our facilities. This decision was made after thoughtful consideration of the current public health situation, including the recent increase in COVID-19 diagnoses, the presence of the Delta variant in Maricopa County, and current guidance from the Centers for Disease Control. In accordance with this requirement, as well as in consideration of reduced travel, the desire for increased attendance, and the possible limiting the number of people required to attend, participate, and administer an in-person governing board meeting, I've made the decision and I'm announcing that our August 24, 2021 governing board meeting for the Community College District will be held remotely. The remote board meeting will follow the same process as we've employed over the past few months. It continues to be my hope and my interest that this is only for this coming month, and by the time we get to September, we will have more security in meeting publicly as a body in safe surroundings and allowing public to attend as we would prefer. So with that, that's my comment for the next meeting. And I want to thank all board members for being present at today's meeting to review these items, keeping in mind then that we will convene next week and we will do so remotely thanks to the talent and skill of our technology department. So with that, board members, I'm going to adjourn today's meeting. And again, thank you for your time. We'll connect next week. Thank you.